is understand and no one can fathom. He gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even youths grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall, but those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint.
Kids, crazy as their old man.
They dug up the corner of Jackson and Main, putting in the sidewalk. You boys wouldn't recognize it now. You, I doubt they'd recognize you. They hardly know me when I walk by. It's like I died with you. It's like we boys never existed. That's all I got for you today. Lock him with your right, Desmond.
Stop it. Do you hear me?
Stop them, save me whipping them both. This way I just whip the one that wins.
Tom! Tom! Wake up. Can you hear me?
What the hell have you done?
You can't hear me. It's mice.
Ship that basket.
I got it. Is he breathing?
Al, you hear me? kisses. You tell him the world's a soft and gentle place.
Al's gonna be okay. Another man's life, that is the most egregious sin in the Lord's sight. Nothing hurts his heart so much. Himself sometimes. Your daddy denied that ain't the real him. I wish he knew him like I did before the war.
We sound, Desmond?
Like a heavenly host of angels, Mama.
Now you know it's a sin to tell a lie, especially in this place.
Well, I ain't never said there was sang an angel.
Oh. What's going on out there, Desmond?
Oh. Get it out! Get it out!
Severed artery. Get some sutures.
Yes, doctor.
Put some pressure on it. Did you apply this tourniquet?
Yes, sir.
Nice work. You might have saved this boy's life. You staying with us? You'll be okay.
What's your name, son? Gilbert.
Yes, sir. You stay with us. You'll be okay. You feel pain? Stay with us.
Army physical's that way. This is for giving blood. Are you all right?
Oh, no, that's not mine. I'm fine. Thank you for asking, though.
What do you need?
belt. I lent it to the boy who had the accident. My pants don't hold up so good without it.
Well, I don't have your belt.
No, I know that ma'am is out there. It's right out there with the boy still.
Okay. I'm just here to take blood.
I'll give you mine.
Okay. Go to that room over there and wait with the others. I'll call you.
Desmond, no, ma'am, my first time. I always dreamed about being a doctor, but didn't get much school.
You might be a little dizzy when we're done. Is somebody picking you up?
No, ma'am, walking back.
Where do you live?
Fort Hill, ma'am.
That's a ways.
Just 5 or 6 miles. I cut through the woods. 7 that way.
You must really like the woods.
Yes, ma'am, sure do.
Okay, put some pressure here. You okay?
Yeah.
Where are you going looking all spruced and nice?
Met someone yesterday. Nurse over at the hospital, her name's Dorothy Schutte. I'm gonna marry her.
Goodness, does she know that?
Well, not yet. She's about to.
Have you ever even spoken to a woman? Anyone that's not family?
Spoke to her. Well, in that case, come give your brother a big hug.
Keep your greasy paws off of me. Wish me luck, Mama.
Good luck. Grab a seat. You ever given blood before?
Yes, ma'am, I have.
You're the belt man.
Desmond, yes, ma'am.
Well, Desmond, we can't take your blood 2 days in a row.
That's good. I came to get mine back.
You what?
My blood needed back.
Well, it don't work like that. We can't just give it back to you.
Well, you got to. Ever since you stuck me with that needle, my heart's been beating real fast. Every time I think about you, it beats faster still.
I never heard that one before. It's pretty corny.
It is. Well, it's a shame. I don't practice that all night. No good?
I didn't say that.
What's the difference between an artery and a vein?
What are you talking about?
The boy's accident.
Arteries burn blood.
And veins?
Bleed. I think you need to practice your boy-girl dating talk at home before you come out.
Yeah, probably do.
I'll give you a book if you're that interested.
On dating?
On blood. Another medical question, perhaps?
No, I just think you're the prettiest thing I've ever seen.
Well, that's because I'm sitting in the dark.
Just beautiful. I didn't think you'd mind.
You didn't ask.
I thought you might have liked it.
Well, I might have if you'd asked. You coming?
Why didn't you say nothing to us?
Because he would have tried to talk me out of it. I know what I'm doing is right.
What about his commandment?
It's not killing anymore. I've protected loads of boys from our church going. There's a war, and they need men. Working in a paper mill ain't gonna save this country.
Looks like a movie star. Good hat. Reminds me of how Artie Gittins looked in his uniform when we went to France. Remember him, Bertha?
Don't talk.
What? I'm just saying how snappy Artie looked in his uniform. All you girls certainly seem to think so. He had them flocking to him. He was most proud of. Hope that when our hell gets shot, it's through the front of his jacket. Like a simple entry wound, not much mass. Artie got hit in the back, blew most of his guts and intestines out his front, awful everywhere. Wrecked his uniform entirely. It was lucky he was dead, so he never knew how awful his uniform was.
Help me, Desmond Doss. Or are you just gonna leave me stranded?
I'll help you, but it's gonna cost you.
What?
A kiss.
That is pure blackmail.
Well, yes, ma'am, it is, but that is still my condition. That's deep. Slap me, are you? If I fall off, I'm gonna take you with me.
Kiss me and find out.
What? I have to enlist. I can't stay here while all them go fight for me.
Yes, you can.
Dorothy,
you can stay here.
I have to. I'm gonna be a medic. I figure I'll be saving people, not killing them.
I have to go to work and I'll be late. Are you gonna ask me to marry you or what?
I don't know. You're still gonna have me?
Well, I wouldn't know. You haven't asked.
Well, I'm asking you. With all my heart and then some, will you marry me?
Then yes. Yes, I will.
They come see you here.
Yeah. These three were my best friends. I grew up with them. I got into trouble with them, chased girls with them. I enlisted with them. Now my friends are there. Covered in dirt and grass and eaten by worms. I don't want to have to visit my sons here.
Daddy, I signed up already. I couldn't do otherwise, Pop. Everybody else is doing
it. You mean everybody else? Like everybody else jumps in, does things quick without thinking, like the damn idiot fools we were. You know, and soldiers who live, they live because they can do that. You can't. You gotta sit and think and pray about everything. I mean, look at you. You're doing it right now. You won't be able to live with yourself if you go.
No, I won't be able to live with myself if I don't. I'm gonna be a medic. And that's gonna be my way to service.
See, there you go, thinking it all out. But you figure this war is just going to fit in with you? Your ideas?
Says
It's because no one else here can read. The testicles there belong to a man calling himself Hollywood.
Yeah, well, they look like they belong to a smaller guy.
No testicles. Oh, hey, we just got these shoes.
Hey, Bruce Nolan, not a Red Hood. Where you from?
Virginia.
Oh, hillbilly, huh? You marry your first cousin?
Just
That's Smitty over there whipping Kaczynski's ass.
Like you were doing any better, Chowderhead?
Hey, I didn't want to embarrass you.
Paul Kaczynski, nice to meet you.
Hey, Big Paul.
What'd you say your name was?
Desmond Doss.
That's Tex Lewis over there. Thinks he's some kind of cowboy. And Vito Ranelli. Now, he may be small, but he is a bulldog.
Hey, Desmond.
This handsome guy right here is Lucky Ford.
Hey.
That's Walker and Pinnock over there pretending they're card sharks.
No, pipe down, Greaser, right?
Unless you want to put your money where your mouth is.
Oh, hey. Old, good book, right?
Sorry.
I think Lucky's got a good book, right, Lucky?
It's a good read.
Attention! Line up! Move it! Let's go! Move it! Move it!
Very strange-looking individual, if you don't mind me saying so, Private. Name?
Andy Walker.
How long have you been dead, son?
Sir?
I am not sir! I am Sergeant Howe or Sarge! Sir, you say for useless people!
The name is Ghoul, you say?
Walker! Sergeant!
Ghoul it is!
Yes, Sergeant!
There's something off in your presentation, Private. Can't place it. Is it your hair? Is it the wrinkle in your trousers?
I have a knife in my foot, Sarge.
Oh, yes. Of course. That's it, the knife. What is your name, soldier?
Speedy Riker.
No, your name is Private Idiot. Do you know why?
Because I have a knife in my foot.
Who placed the knife there, Private?
It was an accident, Sarge. It was playing stretch.
I'm heartened by the knowledge you did not place it there with intention. Who threw the knife?
I did, Sergeant. Private Kaczynski.
You look part Indian. To what tribe do you belong, son?
No, I'm Polish.
Wrong. I believe you must have Cherokee or Shawnee blood in you.
No, sir.
Are you contradicting me? You wagon-burning son of a bitch!
No, Sergeant!
Let me see your Indian war cry, son! What is your animal spirit? Are you a garter snake?
No, Sergeant!
Are you a chipmunk?
No, Sergeant!
Are you a dancing radar?
No, Sergeant!
Are you contradicting me, Private?
No, Sergeant!
Son,
then I shall henceforth call you Chief as a sign of great respect to your people.
Thank you, Sergeant!
Are you grinning at me, boy, or is that your natural state?
No, Sergeant.
Name, Private?
Desmond Dawes.
I have seen stalks of corn with better physiques. Makes me want to pull an ear off, Private. Can you carry your weight?
Yes, Sergeant.
Should be easy for you, then. Corporal.
Sergeant.
Make sure you keep this man away from strong winds.
Yes, Sergeant.
Private Idiot.
Yes, Sergeant. Raise your foot. Higher. Everyone outside, now. Move it. I said move it.
All right, just get in my uniform, Sergeant.
Should I ask him to, Corporal?
No memory of it, Sarge.
I believe any man who takes such pride in his natural naked state will surely enjoy the brisk of the outdoors. Now move your privates, private parts.
Move it! You son of an exhibitionist!
I'm gonna teach you how to tie a bowline knot so you can get your sorry asses down from a height so I may then kick them. Cradle-oo. This is the rabbit hole. The rabbit comes out of his hole. Runs around the tree, goes back into the hole. All right? Let's go.
good, Tex. Keep struggling, Teach. Have you ever roped a goat, Hollywood?
No, Sarge.
Have you ever looked into a goat's eyes?
No, Sarge.
Good, that would be unnatural.
You know if you don't breathe, you'll die.
Mm-hmm.
Good, Private Indian. Congratulations, Greaseball. You just fell 50 feet and broke your neck. Brilliant. Private Vito Vanilli. You strangled yourself, numbnuts. Are you a fan of Benito?
No, Sergeant!
Get taller. If you're American, you'd be taller. What do we got here, Doss? One for each titty. You were tying a bowline, boy. Not building a bra. What is so funny, Corporal?
Couldn't tell you, Sergeant.
Come on! Come on, ladies! Pick it up! Move it! Move it! I want to see some fire here! A little hustle! Show me something! Run like you mean it! Down, down, down! Let's go with that time, boys! It's that time! Snap, snap! Move! I want to see you work! Let's go! Dig, dig, dig! Don't forget behind your ears! Let's go! Move! I bet you're enjoying this, you naked degenerate! Let's go! Hustle! Let's go! What are we waiting on? Let's go! Move your ass! Get the wood! Get the ball! Don't get splinters! Drive! Drive!
Chief, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Move! What the hell is wrong with you? No one said take a rest! Move your asses to the finish line! Move! Move! Hustle! Hustle! Get your asses across that line!
Nice work, Doc!
This is a personal gift from the United States government to each and every one of you. A standard issue U.S. rifle, caliber 30, M1, clip fed, shoulder fired semi-automatic weapon designed to bring death and destruction to the enemy. This is to be your lover, your mistress, your concubine, perhaps the only thing in life you'll ever truly love.
Fellas, let's dance. Grab a girl.
Don't point your gun forward. I do not want to be shot today. No matter how much you are tempted, place the weapon by your side. Pay attention. Problem, Private Cornstalk. Is there not one in your size? Or is it the color that is the issue?
No, sir. I was told I don't have to carry a weapon.
Come again. Step forward, Private. I can't be hearing this right.
Well, I'm sorry, Sergeant. I can't touch a gun.
What exactly is the problem?
No problem, just a mistake. I told the Army when I joined up.
It's not possible. Do you know why it's not possible, Private?
No, sir.
Because the United States Army does not make mistakes. So if there's a problem, you must be that problem.
I was just never supposed to be sent to a rifle company.
He's a CO, sir. You're a conscientious objector. Join the Army.
Well, no, sir. I'm a conscientious cooperator.
Are you screwing with me, Doss?
No, sir. I volunteered. I ain't got no problem with wearing my uniform, saluting the flag, and doing my duty. It's just carrying a gun and taking a human life.
You don't kill. That's all.
Yes, sir. That's all.
You know, quite a bit of killing does occur in war.
Yes, sir.
I mean, that is the essential nature of war.
Yes, sir.
All right. Do you have any other requirements for the United States Army? Is there anything else that we can do to ensure that you have a comfortable stay here with us?
He doesn't want to work on Saturday, sir.
Well, Saturdays, I'm a Seventh-day Adventist, so Saturday is my Sabbath, so I'm not allowed to work then.
I don't think that poses a problem, do you, Sergeant? We should simply ask the enemy not to invade on the Sabbath because Private Doss hears a prayer. clear? Now let me tell you my requirements. They're not as complicated as yours, they're very simple. As long as you're in this company, under my command, you will obey my orders, period. If you can't do it here, I can't trust you to do it in battle. I'm putting you in for Section 8, psychiatric discharge. Dismissed.
Gentlemen, I want you to meet Private Desmond Doss. Apparently, Private Doss does not believe in violence. He does not practice violence. He will not even deign to touch a weapon. You see, Private Doss is a conscientious objector. So I plead with you, do not look to him to save you on the battlefield. Because he will undoubtedly be too busy wrestling with his conscience to assist.
Sarge, that's not true,
Private,
Sarge.
As you were. Now, I realize some of you might have strong feelings about this. It is what we men fight for. To defend our rights, to protect our women and children. Even if Private Doss's beliefs might cause women and children to die. So I will expect everyone in this company to give Private Doss the full measure of respect he is due for the short time he will be with us. Am I clear?
Yes, Sergeant!
What you got there, Desi?
You know what that is?
It just seems kind of small. It's half the Bible for half the man.
For Pete's sake, Smitty, even back his Bible.
I remember speaking to you. So how come you don't fight? Are you thinking better than this?
No.
What if he was attacked?
Whoa!
Say it like that. Bible says to turn the other cheek, don't it? Yeah, see, I don't think this is a question of religion, fellas. I think this is cowardice. Plain and simple. Is that right, Doss? Eat chicken shit, that. Well, go on. Take a poke! Tell you what, I'm gonna give you a free shot. Right there. Hit me, Doss. Go on. Please give it back, Smitty.
Please give it back, Smitty.
Do you hear voices, Desmond?
No, sir.
But I understand that God talks to you, is that right?
Sir, I'm not a crazy person.
Is that how you feel most people regard you, a crazy person?
I'm different, I know that, but I'm not gonna pretend to be something I'm not. I am what I am.
It sounds lonely. You lonely? So you don't hear voices?
No, sir. I pray to God and I like to think he hears me, but it ain't a conversation. Like the one we're pretending to have right now.
Pretending, Private?
Well, yes, sir. I know all you really want to do is give me a Section 8 and drum me out of the Army, but I'm not off. Up above, I just simply believe what I believe.
Well, I'm trying to understand, all right? Was it God who told you not to pick up a rifle?
God says not to kill. That's one of his most important commandments.
Most people take that to mean don't commit murder. War is a completely different set of circumstances.
And Jesus said, a new commandment I give unto you, that you love one another, just as I have loved you.
This is Satan himself we're fighting. Surely, as a good Christian, you can see that.
I can't see that, sir, and that is why I joined up. But I'm sorry, I will not bear arms.
His religious views are certainly unique, but they do not constitute grounds for Section 8 discharge.
How am I supposed to maintain discipline with a man like that in my unit?
I don't know.
But he's a legitimate conscientious objector, and he must be allowed to work as a combat medic, provided he qualifies in all other areas of his training.
Perhaps we could help make Lehman his idea.
Yeah, you restrict him to barracks and KP. He throws God at you. You throw hell right at him. I want him gone.
Doss. This isn't good for anybody.
Sure ain't what I joined up for.
It's not about what you joined up for. It's about the lives of every man in here. And yours, son. It's time you quit this. Finish getting dressed and I'll walk you down. It's okay, Doss. There's no shame in this. Doss. Brother Doss, can you identify the men that beat you?
No, Sarge.
Are you saying that you don't know who attacked you?
I never said I was attacked, Sarge.
Well, what the hell are you saying, Doss? You bruised half your body sleeping.
I sleep pretty hard.
Plan on getting wet this weekend. Make sure you put on a hat.
Next!
I don't want anyone coming back pissing cream.
Wait, you don't want none for your coffee, Sarge?
How about a shot right now, Smitty?
You're speaking from experience, Sarge.
You have to ask your mom about backwards.
I'm afraid I can't authorize your pass. This is a furlough for men who have passed the basic training.
Well, so, respectfully, sir, I have. I put in for this furlough 3 weeks ago. I'm getting married this afternoon.
It says you're not rifle qualified.
Well, I'm not required to carry a rifle, sir. Colonel Stelzer,
Colonel Stelzer's determination was Doss must be allowed to work as a combat medic, provided he qualifies in all other areas of his training. And you have not qualified on the rifle range, Private. Pretty clear. Show me you know how to handle a rifle, and I'll sign your first. Corporal Cannon.
Talk!
And Private Doss, you're fired.
I won't touch a rifle, sir.
I'm not asking you, Private! That is a direct order from the company commander!
For God's sake, Doss. You stop this nonsense and quit.
Refuse. And I will have no recourse but to court-martial you. And you will spend the duration of the war in a military prison.
I can, sir.
Sometimes men just get cold feet.
Some men might. Not my Desmond.
I believe in this book as much as any man. And just like any man, I wrestle with my conscience, but what do you do when everything you value in this world is under attack?
I don't know, sir. I ain't got answers to questions that big. But I also feel like my values are under attack. And I don't know why.
I don't give a rat's ass about your principles because the Japs don't. If one of them attacks you and some wounded soldier, what are you gonna do? Hit him with your Bible.
I'm prepared to give my life for my men.
You don't win wars by giving up your life. Look, I'm only here because I don't want to see you rotting in a prison cell. Plead guilty, throw yourself at the mercy of the court. Maybe they'll let you go home and pray. Let the brave men out there go and win this war. If I can't convince you, maybe she can.
They wouldn't let me call you.
I knew it wasn't your making. What have they done to you?
It's okay, I'm all right. Just went a couple of rounds with the wall and lost.
They're saying you could go to prison, Desmond. Leavenworth. There must be some other way.
I don't know what that could be. I've done everything they asked me except this one thing. I'm being treated like a criminal just because I won't kill.
You tried. Nobody can say you didn't. But who are you going to save in prison?
Probably nobody.
And why can't you just pick up the stupid gun and wave it around? You don't have to use it. Just meet them halfway.
Thought I can't do that.
Yes, you can. It's just pride. Pride and stubbornness. Don't confuse your will with the Lord's.
That's how you could live with me. I'd never be the man that I want to be in your eyes.
I fell in love with you because you weren't like anyone else. And you didn't try to be. Do not think for one moment that you'll disappoint me. I will love you no matter what. I don't know what he's gonna do. He loses no matter what.
We want him to plead guilty, but then he'll get a dishonorable discharge.
Otherwise, he fights him and he for sure goes to prison.
Either way, he'll call him a coward, and I don't see how he can live with that.
Oh, thank you, Dorothy. If you get to talk to him, tell him that we love him and that we're praying for him.
We're praying for both of you.
I will. Bye-bye.
I wish to speak to Brigadier General Musgrove.
Not without an appointment, you can. That would be quite impossible.
If you would kindly tell him, Corporal Thomas Doss would appreciate a brief word.
He's in a very important meeting.
I fought with him in France at Belleau Wood. He was my captain. Please, ma'am. It's most vital.
Be over in a minute. You'll be home safe and sound like nothing ever happened.
This is a hearing into the matter of Private Desmond Doss. The charge is disobeying a series of direct orders from his commanding officer. How says the defendant?
Private Doss wishes to enter a not guilty plea.
Is that so, Private? I thought this was agreed. You wanted to enter some sort of plea bargain.
Yes, sir, but I changed my mind.
Just like that? You wish to proceed to a court martial?
Yes, sir.
Well, on your head then, Private. Proceed.
Your Honor, Private Doss waves his morality at us like it's some kind of badge of honor. He flaunts his contempt by directly disobeying a series of direct orders from his commanding officer when the very best of our young men are sacrificing their lives against...
You okay?
Yes.
Are they still deliberating?
Yes.
go take this in there.
I can't. Strictly military personnel.
Well, then you get one of them to take it in.
They know to help. They're fixing to bury him.
There is only one question that any military court need ask of the accused. Do you deny disobeying Colonel Sangston's direct orders?
Well, do you, Private?
No, sir, I don't.
Why are you contesting it, then? Why is it so important to you, given you refuse to even touch a weapon to serve in a combat unit?
Because when the Japanese attacked Pearl Harbor, I took it personal. Everyone I knew was on fire to join up, including me. There were two men in my hometown. Declared 4F unfit, they killed themselves because they couldn't serve. I had a job in a defense plant. I could have taken a deferment, but that ain't right. It isn't right that other men should fight and die, that I would just be sitting at home safe. I need to serve. I got the energy and the passion to serve as a medic. Right in the middle with the other guys, no less danger, just while everybody else is taking life, I'm gonna be saving it. With the world so set on tearing itself apart, it doesn't seem like such a bad thing to me to want to put a little bit of it back together.
Sorry, sir. Nobody's allowed to
go. No, you don't understand. My son is the defendant.
I understand, sir, but nobody's allowed
to go. I have information.
While the sentiments expressed are laudable, the facts of the charge seem incontestable, so what the hell is going on out there? Let him go. That's a Greek war uniform.
It is, sir. Sir, I need to show you this.
With respect, sir, you are no longer a member of the military. You are unable to attend this hearing. I'm sorry.
Is that truly the way it works, sir? You fight for your country, you lose so much that was dear to you, and then you're done with it. The uniform's forgotten. You have no voice.
You were at least...
I was Sir Annabella Wood.
Twice decorated, I see.
Sir.
I take it you are the private's father?
I am, sir. Thomas Doss.
Then, as a former military man, you know there are laws here.
Sir, I know the law, and I know my son is protected by those laws. They're framed in our Constitution. And I believe in them as he does. They're why I went and fought, to protect them. At least that is what I thought I was doing, because if it wasn't for that, then I have no idea what the hell I was doing there, sir.
Thank you, Corporal Doss. Let me have the letter. You must go. Defendant's rights as a conscientious objector are protected by an act of Congress, and he cannot be compelled to waive those rights. That includes, in this case, he's disobeying orders to bear arms. Signed, Brigadier General Musgrove, War Services Commander, Washington, D.C. Colonel?
I withdraw the charges, sir.
Then this case is dismissed. Private Doss, you are free to run into the hellfire of battle without a single weapon to protect yourself. You may resume your duties and begin training as a combat medic.
Where is he? Go, straight after. I begged him to stay. I told him you'd want to see him.
Thank you.
reckon it will you save your chrome for when we get there.
Feels like I was here.
In the room!